If you are a Linux user, you have definitely heard about Linux Swap, but you may not know exactly what it is and how to use it. Time to change that. I mention Linux Swap and swappiness in almost every video on things to do after installing Linux. You can watch these videos in this playlist. You probably know that Linux Swap is somehow related to RAM, and swappiness can affect your system performance. In this video, I will explain you what it is and how to use it in little more details. You will learn what is Linux Swap, do you need Linux Swap, what are swap partition and swap file, how to create a swap file, what is swappiness and how to adjust it. What is Linux Swap? The Linux kernel usually uses your RAM memory to store temporary information. When there is no enough RAM space, the Linux kernel takes some of this information from the RAM and writes it to the swap space on a hard drive. This is called the swapping process. This way your Linux system can release some RAM space and doesn't crash due to lack of memory. So, Linux Swap is a very useful way to extend the RAM, because it provides the necessary additional memory when the RAM space has been exhausted and the process has to be continued. This is why, when you install a Linux distribution, the installation wizard usually asks you to assign a space for a swap partition. Do you need Linux Swap? This is a question many novice users ask themselves when they begin to discover Linux. In fact, this will depend on the use and the amount of RAM your computer has. Nevertheless, having a swap space is desirable, even if you have a lot of RAM. For example, usually when your RAM gets full and the Linux kernel has no space to write into, your system will crash. On the other hand, if you have a swap space, it will be used by the Linux kernel, and your system will keep working, though much slower. So, it is safer to have a swap space. Note, swap space has one disadvantage. It is much slower than RAM. Adding a swap space won't make your computer faster. It will only help to overcome some limitations posed by the RAM size. There are two options for swap space: a swap partition and a swap file. Swap partition. Swap partition is just part of your hard drive which is reserved for a swap space. It is sort of hard-coded in your hard drive, so it's usually not that easy to change. I recommend that you create a swap partition during the installation of your Linux distribution. If your computer has 1 GB of RAM or less, then the swap partition should be twice the size of the RAM. If you have between 2 and 4 GB of RAM, the size of the swap partition should be equal to the RAM. For RAM of 8 GB, swap can be half of RAM. Finally, if you have more than 8 GB of RAM, then it is enough to have 2 4 GB of swap. But everything depends on your use case. You can check type and size of your swap with this command. This is the size of my swap partition. Linux swap file. Alternatively to a swap partition, you can create a Linux swap file after the installation. The modern Linux kernel allows swapping to a swap file instead of a swap partition. A swap file has an advantage over a swap partition that you can change the size of your swap anytime easily simply by changing a swap file size. If you want to create a swap file, run this command first. Now this command will create 1 GB swap file. Replace one with the value you need. Next, you have to set the correct permissions, then format the file to swap. Finally, enable the swap. If you want the changes to be permanent, you need to edit the /etc/fstab file. Open it and add the following. Ctrl+O to save the changes and Ctrl+X to exit. In the end, check the status of the swap file. Here it is. How to remove or edit a Linux swap file. In case you need to remove or edit a Linux swap file for any reason, you first deactivate it and delete the actual Linux swap file. If you want to increase or decrease a swap file size, you create a new swap file of desired size. If you want only to remove the swap file, remove swap file entry in the fstab file. Swappiness and how to adjust the swappiness value. Swappiness is a property of the Linux kernel to define how often the swap file will be used. As you already know, RAM is faster than a hard drive. So every time your system needs to use swap, you will notice that some processes and applications will run slower. However, you can adjust the system to use much more RAM than swap. This can help to improve overall system performance. Normally, the default swappiness value is 60. The smaller the value, the more of your RAM will be used. Swap tendency is defined by this formula. Swappiness is here. I'm not going into technical details of this formula. You can pause and read it if you are curious. To check your current swappiness value, run this command. You should see the value of 60. By the way, I copy all these commands in the description. If you want to modify the default value, you need to edit the file /etc/systctl.conf and add the following: vm.swappiness equal 10. 10 is the most commonly recommended value. Also, this settings is recommended when you have more than 4 GB of RAM. Save the file and close it with Ctrl+O and Ctrl+X key shortcuts. In order to apply the changes, you need to reboot the system. Now the swappiness value is 10. This way your Linux kernel will use more RAM and less swap, but it still will swap when your RAM memory gets critically full. Linux swap is a technical concept, but knowing how it works can improve the performance of your system. If you have anything to add to this video, let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching.